Still no sight of missing university student. How you gonna welcome? This is Links W7 TV News Report, and we'll be right back with the details to come.
Welcome to Links W7 TV News Report, providing you with the best in local and international news updates. This is a place where you can get the most reliable and informative news information. Links W7 TV News Report.
Welcome back and thanks for joining us. This is Links W7 TV News Report. The police said that they are currently in receipt of preliminary cell phone records belonging to the 27-year-old university student who went missing shortly after 7 a.m. from the Orchard Hopewell community on Christmas morning. A senior police officer told reporters that a request for the record was sent to one of the national telecommunications service providers. Preliminary information, according to the police, showed that the cell phone of the missing woman, Shannon Evans, a University of the West Indies student, was last connected to cell phone towers in Hopewell, Trial, and Montpelier areas. The community of Orchard is located between the three cell towers that provided the data. This latest information may suggest that the young woman may still be located in the area, and as such, the police have sought the assistance of the Jamaica Constabulary Force to search the heavily wooded areas where there are several undeveloped lots.
Saturday morning, we get a call. Say she went up the Opel up our baby father. So me just then say me feel come fear, but she said me no for better come. Our baby father will drop her down. So me say alright, so me start watch my bus. And then me get a call back say, for our baby father say, Shelly run gone on the road. She run away. So me say, what? And then he say, well, I never go look if he see her. So in go and look and you know, see her. When me catch up, you know, we start a hunt for her. So me try call her phone, she not answer. Till me know if I him or Johnny call and get her. And then when he get her now, we start communicate from this. And she started telling me, say, she go jump. He said, no man, how if you do that? So then link me that phone with fear connection. She there Kingston, and then we link one away, my niece's phone, Atlanta. So we start talk and we start beg her. I said, no man, how do that, man? Say nobody no love her. He said, we love you, man. And we start talk. And we start coming till you calm her down. And when you calm her down, he said, right, daddy, I want to talk to you. I said, what now, Shelly? She said, Daddy, where you there? I said, we out of road, man. Where you there? Where you there? Come out of the bush. He said, I feel comfy. I said, but I can't comfy. Because if me come, I don't know where you there. I feel comfy. So we start talking, now ask her, where she there? Where she there? And she said, first she said she there on a river. Next thing, she said she there come up on a hill. So I tell her, I said, look if she's in any house or any light post, so come towards us, so we're on the main road. So we keep on driving up and down the road to see if she should have come out of the bush. And we did the look whole time. So we said, no man, something wrong. That time she's still up on the phone, long. We're up on the phone with approximately almost 2 hours. Until the phone cut off. That means, boy, if he said battery dead. Huh?
Dead.
If he said battery dead. So from then on, we've been looking for Saturday evening till night come now. Come back yesterday morning, Sunday, whole day. We can one team of man, lots of people yesterday, over 100 people. This morning, the police give me assurance now, so this morning we get the canine dog. So, fortunately, the dog is here, but still nothing. She good, you know, man. She good, fussy. Fussy, like, you know, dress up and she's that kind of person. She alright, man, but, yeah, man. Our mother, the man our mother can't agree neither. They can't agree because she's a woman who like do nothing. You know some people like do nothing. So my mother clean, my mother love when he place tidy and he place and wash and you know like she not another place. So my man in other so quite well say, fix up the place, man, a place who was strange, I can't come in and you never can tell. Me sick too, but me the girl. For you can have your child missing. And you're alright. You can alright, but how we go. Yeah, so we hopefully you can see her. Even if he's dead, whether I like her, you know. But at this moment now, to the amount of search, what we do, it start to tell me start to think different. If one day she's still on the complex, or maybe she gone, she take a drive, she gets a drive somewhere, she go over, some community take a drive, you know. But the amount of search we do in this, and as you see how far we are now from the main, that means, I'm sure she won't come so far, unless she try to find the main and come further in the bush.
The request for additional assistance followed the provision of one K-9 dog from the Jamaica Constabulary Force that joined the search on Monday morning, the third day of the search for the woman. Evans had reportedly visited her child's father in Orchard when she said to have run from the house. It is reported that the young woman had last had a conversation with her father, Kitson Evans, on the cell phone, asking him to come and get her. She reportedly told her father that she was in a riverbed with no water. We'll continue to track this story and provide more information to come on this. This has been Links 007 TV News Report. Thanks for watching.